Hola amigos, what is up, and welcome back to Let's Play Super Mario Galaxy. I should stop saying things like, "Aw man, I'm gonna be working so hard on an upload schedule," because then everything just goes wrong. To be fair, this time around, it didn't really affect Super Mario Galaxy that much. It was a problem with the external hard drive that I use, which affects other projects, because I have a lot of the stuff from multiplayer things, and in fact, the entire Yoshi's Woolly World saved onto the external hard drive, so that's a bit of a pain in the butt, and it was difficult to not be able to access my files, but regardless, I got that figured out. And I did manage to, you know, fix the problem. A lot of the other time as well was just me wanting to stream instead of record, because I don't know, I'll talk about that in a bit, but for now, we're gonna start up the Playtime Galaxy. Playtime has ended. Heavy Metal Mecha Bowser. Oh man, the Mecha Bowser fight from Sunshine? That was pretty cool. That's the Mecha Bowser. Yep. Looks just as good as I remember it. Yes. Welcome to the galaxy. Anyway, Playtime Galaxy is kind of interesting because it takes place in like a child's bedroom, and it's a pretty small child's bedroom too. It's just like, there's no door. How do you get in here? Does the floor give away? Does the ceiling give away? I don't know. But regardless of any of that, it's not actually that small of a bedroom because it hosts an entire galaxy in it, so I guess I can't complain about the size too much. Playtime Galaxy is one of the more interesting galaxies out there. It's got a very childish theme, which, to be fair, works well with me. I'm a very childish person. But it's also got a lot of a mechanical focus to it as well, because of just the toy aspect of it. You've got places made of building blocks and, like, gears. It's like a Meccano set brought to life, if anyone knows about those. But regardless, Playtime Galaxy has some interesting things. I don't actually think I've ever been up on this roof. What do you have to say? Our friends are trapped over there. Okay, well, you don't have very much interesting to say. Is there anything up in this? I can look down into it. There's nothing. There's nothing. He's dead, Jim. So, this galaxy introduces a new-ish mechanic? Gravity floors. Basically, we're pulled to whatever direction the gravity floor is in, and objects themselves are also pulled into that as well. So we can do like that. We can do like that. And that robot was firing a laser beam. Interesting. We'll deal with him in a sec. We can spin this, get some star bits, fall in a hole. I like this hole. Feels like it was meant for me. Weird. And more importantly, we can move on to this gravity floor. I believe there's a one-up back here. You know what? I don't explore this path very often. I'm gonna check. So far, it's just two coins. A power mushroom! I never knew that was there, but that might be very helpful, actually. Because we might be taking some damage. But, let's get back to the beaten path here, shall we? Let's not fall into death. So yeah, basically, you get the gimmick of this gravity platforming stuff. Goes toward the pink side or the green side later on. There's a lot of mechanical focus in this, which I kinda like. I'm actually a big fan of, like, mechanical levers and whatnot. I find that whole thing to be pretty interesting. Also, I find this jump to be pretty interesting. Oops, nope, I didn't actually make it in there. But we go out the smokestack, and we go on to another area, and this introduces a new power-up? We don't want this new power-up, but we're gonna get this new power-up. Go over here to this mystery coin, and... it's the Spring Mushroom! We turn into Spring Mario! As you'd expect, Spring Mario jumps really high! Problem is... Spring Mario is also insanely difficult to control. Very difficult to control and just... is not that fun. I think, honestly, out of all the power-ups, this is one of the weakest ones as far as just, like, being good, which is a shame. Considering that it's actually a really neat idea, being able to jump super high. You can take damage to cancel out the Spring Mushroom, and that's actually what I'm going to be doing right here. Because there is a secret to show off as well. What I need to do is do a backflip jump off of that. And then go over here. Now there's a mushroom, a one-up over here. But inside this hole there's also a toy train. It doesn't do anything. We can, like, try to shoot a star bit at it and it hits the wall here, but... it doesn't do anything, but it's a really weird and kind of cool Easter egg. Just this toy train being back here. There's nothing else in that room. Kind of reminds me actually a lot of the underwater book in Mario Sunshine. Where when you're doing, 6-3 in Mario Sunshine? I think it's Noki Bay Episode 3 in Mario Sunshine. And you're doing trying to find the red coins underwater, and there's just this door that leads to a book, and I don't know why it's there, but it's kind of a neat Easter egg. I don't know. It's weird. Maybe it's a carryover from something that they plan to do. Probably is. But it's pretty cool. I don't know. I like it. But I don't know. Spring Mario is just... it's not my favorite power-up in this game. A lot of the power-ups in this game are kind of... you only use them for a little bit of time. You only use them on, like, one mission. And they tend to have, you know... they go away as soon as you get hit, which makes sense. It's a Mario game. I don't know, though. A lot of them just seem, like, very one note. And even, like, the good power-ups, like the Fire Flower. Fire Flowers are pretty great. In most Mario games, they... see, that's what I mean by Spring Mushroom being very difficult to control, by the way. It's stupid. That's your sign of a good time. It's stupid. Let's just get Spring Mushroom again. Problem is, since you lose the mushroom for taking damage, this robot becomes a pain in the ass to dodge his laser. But you want to be careful. There we go. There we go, now we're cooking with gas. Cooking with springs. It's not usually how people cook. But screw it, it's how I do it, it's how my family has done it for generations. We cook using springs and rotund Italian men. It's how we've always done it. It's just, it's a family tradition, don't question it. But anyway, 9 minutes later, we actually get into the Mecha Bowser fight. Now, if you're expecting a big fight on the roller coaster like it was in Sunshine, you're gonna be disappointed. On the other hand, however, Mecha Bowser does play a lot more like a Shadow of the Colossus level, in a way. The objective is to just attack Bowser's weak points for massive damage, basically causing a lot of structural damage along the way, and helping you get up top onto where the weak point is. And again, it reminds me an awful lot of Shadow of the Colossus, and that is a good game. I would not be averse to doing a Let's Play of that game, except I have not beaten it. I really enjoyed what I played of it, mind you, but I have not beaten it because I don't own a PS2. I have it on PS3, so I can just play it on that. I should get around to finishing it one of these days. It is a very good game. Heard a lot of good things about Last Guardian, too. I don't know exactly how good Last Guardian is, but I've heard a lot of people like it. Heard it's got some very clever and creative puzzles to it, so that's fine. I want to be careful around this guy, or else we're going to have a bad time. I wanted to be careful, because in a failed recording... Oh, that bat almost knocked me off. I was going to say, in a failed recording, that first bat knocked me off. But that guy almost did. Alright, now we have to use the spring mushroom to do stuff. Problem is, there's a fireball cannon and a magic Koopa. Go get a coin. There's also a spring mushroom over there, so I think I'm just gonna grab this one, actually. In order to save those Gearmos, we're gonna have to grab this spring mushroom. Spring is in the air, but you gotta be careful, because there's not much room to maneuver with this thing. There definitely is a mushroom for error. There we go. Pounded right through your skull. Smash his face in with an iron! There we go. And it just disappears. And a lovely power star here. You're welcome for saving you, strange smoking robot dudes.
Nintendo's finally showing battle damage.
I remember actually seeing, beta texture, or unused textures in Smash Bros. Brawl that indicated that characters would take, like, visual damage as they took damage. Like, there's a version of Meta Knight where his mask is cracked, there's a version of Captain Falcon where his visor on his helmet is cracked. And I think it would have been cool if they had managed to implement that in some way, but at the same time, I can also see why they didn't do that. Because they'd have to make new textures for every character, and... I mean, HAL probably didn't want to put down the time to do that. It would have been cool, but it also really wouldn't have added to the gameplay in any way. It just would have been a nice visual detail. Anyway, mission number two, Mario meets Mario. We're gonna meet Mario. I've never met Mario before, but he seems like a nice guy, so Mario, we're gonna have to meet Mario. There we go, on top of this, what is this supposed to be? I guess it's supposed to be like a toy ray gun or something. Like, some kid goes to a Cracker Barrel, and he goes to the shop at Cracker Barrel and brings home, like, a toy space gun. Something like that. It's like a cheapo toy space gun. We're on the cheapo toy space gun planet, but... How many times can I say cheapo toy space gun? I guess I can talk a little bit about, something. So, for those of you guys who don't know, I've been doing a lot more streaming on my Twitch channel. Part of that was because I was sick, and I didn't want to, like, record video, because, I mean, when I was sick. So it's just like, oh, I'll do a casual, chill stream and stuff, you know, that sounds great. So part of that was due to that, and thankfully I'm mostly over the illness. I take a very long time to get over colds, I've noticed. Colds, like, hit me stupid hard. That's also due to my poor diet and lack of exercise, but no well. So, welcome to Mario. We have met Mario. And while I may have said that Mario seems like a nice guy, Mario's actually a jerk. Notice how his entire body is made of fallaway platforms and lava. For this mission, you definitely need to be careful. This is one of the harder missions out there. And it's not so bad right now, because you have ways to get around it if you fall in the lava, and thankfully, you only need to collect 5 objects here. There is a later mission that we will be able to do once I beat Bowser. So once we get to the Bowser fight at the end of the game, I'll be able to do that mission, and you guys already know what that mission is. But that's gonna be really fun. The weird thing is, too, the mission in question is, like, one that was a huge roadblock for me for a very long time in Mario Galaxy, and in fact, on my Wii, I actually have never beaten that mission on my actual disc. But a supposedly harder version of that mission is also in Mario Galaxy 2, and I beat that one on my first try, but I still haven't beaten the one in Mario Galaxy 1, and I guess I'm also gonna say this as well. This is a lot like Mario 64, where before I did Let's Play, I never 100% completed this game. And Mario 64, I don't know, it's weird, because all of the Mario 3D platformers have some reason or another why I've never bothered to 100% the game. Mario 64 was because I just didn't have an N64 growing up. I was kind of the Sega kid, and I had a Game Gear, so I didn't really get into Mario until, like, later when the GameCube came out. Mario Sunshine, I lost my copy, but Mario Sunshine is also probably the hardest 3D Mario platformer. I'd say that. Somebody's gonna say, like, oh, Mario Galaxy 2 is a lot harder than Sunshine, and just, like, I don't know, because, see, I 100%ed Mario Galaxy 2. I have not yet 100%ed Sunshine, and Sunshine's a much shorter game as well. Like, Mario Galaxy 2 is 242 stars long. For reference's sake, Galaxy 1 is 121, depending on how you play it. There are 121 stars to collect with Mario, and 121 stars to collect with Luigi. But the problem is, to get the 121 with Mario, or 121, you need to beat the game with Luigi, and get all 120 stars with Luigi. In order to get 121 with Luigi, you need to get that 120th with Mario, from what I remember, so it's weird. Anyway, relax for me. Reminds me of my job. For those of you guys who don't know, I'm the ice cream man. Because I work at a, oh god. Wait, what? Hold the phone. There's a black hole there, right? I fell past the black hole. Like, I'm glad that Mario didn't die by suffering spaghettification, but it feels weird that I fell past the black hole. Normally those are, like, supposed to suck you in, so I guess I must have missed the event trigger somewhere? I guess there's a specific flag that Mario needs to pass in order to get sucked in. It's weird, though. I was not expecting that. I was expecting to die, but not to gravity. I was expecting to die to gravity. If that made any sense. Probably did. Alright, so god, we take those. Alright, whatever. As long as I don't, like, fly off into the stratosphere. There's no stratosphere, it's a space bedroom. As long as I don't, like, die, I'm fine. I'm gonna collect this power shroom, though. Oh god, that's a Burbit! It's a good thing I collected that power shroom, I guess. Oh no, 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 no! Oh no, 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 no. Just kill the thing. God, I swear ice physics are, like, the worst in this game. It's not like the ice physics themselves are bad, but it's the advanced movement you have on the ice physics that makes it such a pain in the butt. Like, the ice skating movement you have, it's a cool idea to have that kind of alternate movement on the ice. It's a really neat idea. But the increased momentum you have kind of kicks you in the butt sometimes. Anyway, oh god, that's a lot of Mecha Koopas. I'm going to assume that I need to kill all of them in order to progress. Or I need to do something. I don't see any, like, launch star or anything. And there was literally nothing in that capsule. And is there anything? Hang on, there's a warp pipe down here? Oh, there it is. There it is. And this just takes us to a mystery room. There we go. At least it's a mystery room with a one-up mushroom. It's not so bad. It's a sphere. It's like a weird inverted sphere. Most of this game's, like, big publicity was, oh yeah, Mario can walk around on spherical objects. You got giant boobs, Mario can walk around on. I know that's just what everyone wants. I'm gonna kill all the Mecha Koopas and see what that does. It's been a long time since I rocked and rolled. So we got candles. Hang on. It wants me to blow out the candles, that's what! Now I remember. Now I remember. I thought it was just like, do I gotta kill all the enemies? What are these candles? I don't want to get near them. I don't like getting burned. I don't like getting burned, actually. Not that I make a habit of getting burnt or anything like that. But I remember, I've still got, like, a little bit of scarring from a burn I got once. Come on, I just want to get up onto this ledge. Kill this Mecha Koopa. That's another power mushroom, wow. Problem is, these electric spheres, they home in to an extent. So this is a lot harder than, like, the water turret boss that we saw in Goldleaf Galaxy. Be careful. Especially because I'm a spring, that means I can become a very powerful electromagnet. I've played Mega Man 7. I know about using electricity on springs. It doesn't go well. That's a game I'm gonna have to, I don't know, maybe do a race of at some point, is Mega Man 7. I actually like Mega Man 7 a fair amount. It's not a bad game. It's really weird for a Mega Man game, but it's not a bad game. Just because it's a bad guy doesn't mean it's a bad guy, you know? I hope that made a lot more sense to you guys than it did in my head. Because after I thought about it, it's just like, wait, no, that doesn't really make that much sense. But hey, it's something I said, so it doesn't have to make sense. Because I never make sense. Do you know what the hell I'm talking about? Because I certainly don't have the time. Anyway, I guess we can do Another mission somewhere. Well, there's a mission we're missing in Sea Slide and a mission we're missing in Toy Time. What are we doing on time for this episode? 25 minutes. Let's do the one in Toy Time, because I believe I remember where it is. Yep. It is in Mario Meets Mario. And thankfully, we don't actually have to go meet Mario to get this. But we will have to get some star bits, because remember on the Ray Gun planet, the Ronald Reagan planet. God, what a horrifying planet. But remember on that, like, Space Gun planet. There was a hungry Luma, but I want to get these star bits first. Oh god! Oh no. Because we're gonna have to ride the train. I just like fooling around too. At least I can do amusing things in this game to kill time, like crouch walk. This is my duck walk! Cool, huh? I love, like, cheesy voice acting that's trying to be, like, a cool character. Like, Link in the Zelda CDI games, I actually really love the CDI Link. And, like, the Sonic Says public service announcements from the Sonic the Hedgehog cartoon the Deke made in the 1990s. Stuff like that is just always funny. Kids, there's nothing more cool than being hugged by someone you like. But if someone tries to touch you in a way or in a place that makes you feel uncomfortable, that's no good. Which I mean, to be fair, that is no good if someone tries to touch you in a way or in a place that makes you feel uncomfortable. That's sexual harassment. But, I don't know, it just... The concept of Sonic teaching kids in that voice about the dangers of sexual harassment, and more than just that, the concept of Sonic, voiced by Jaleel White, teaching kids that it's okay to be hugged by someone you like, but if someone tries to touch you in a way, I don't know why, it's just... That is funny to me. Maybe it's because of Jaleel White's voice acting. Did he voice Sonic in that cartoon, actually? I know he voiced Sonic in Sonic Underground. But did he voice Sonic in the other two cartoons as well? I think he did, because the voice sounds really familiar. It sounds like the same voice that he did in Sonic Underground. But it may also just have been like, the voice direction was, for some reason, make him sound like that. But remember kids, there's nothing more cool than being hugged by someone you like. So I'll never be cool. Because I never get hugged by someone I like. Not that I get touched in a way or in a place that makes me feel uncomfortable, because I mean, when that happens, that's no good. It actually has happened to me before, though. I know, I wouldn't, like, call it, like, sexual assault or anything like that. That's not happening. I have been touched in a way or a place that made me feel uncomfortable by kids in school. But then again, like, physical contact in general is not something I'm really a fan of. I am a guy who goes for touchy-feely bullshit sometimes, but I don't actually like touching and feeling. Touching just... I don't know. The most I'd do is a handshake. It's not like I'm gonna walk up to somebody and say, "Aw, man, I really need a hug." It's just like, "Oh, hey, you're somebody I watch on the internet. Let's shake hands. It was nice meeting you." I don't know, but that's just me. Maybe it's just me. I really don't know. You got a star, though. So that's good. Kids, there's nothing more cool than getting the power star that you need to kick Bowser's ass. But if someone tries to touch you in a way or a place that makes you lose all of your life and have to continue from a save point or something like that, I guess that's not very good at all. And that's the moral of the story. Good night, ladies and gentlemen. Good night.